thank you for having me round to your house again. And it's looking lovely. Have you been decorating?
I'm doing a bit of painting and decorating, you know. And you know me, it's just sort of silvery. So I like the bling, you know.
A bit of showbiz sparkle.
Something like that, yeah.
And your home really is important to you, isn't it? Is it nice to be home?
It's nice to be home. That's your wee bubble where you feel secure and safe, where you can put your baffies on, sit down, watch television, and that's you with a cup of tea.
You feel at home here, but you also love getting out and about, and you've just been in America, haven't you?
I've just been in Miami. I met none other than Gloria Estefan.
What was she like?
She was really nice. Really nice.
I won't cry. I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear.
You've met some of the most famous people in the world, so tell me about some of your favourites.
Rod Stewart. He's some man. Oh. He never changes, does he?
It looks amazing, doesn't it?
It's great. It looks great the other day when he was on television.
Did you see him?
I did. Hi, Rod. How you doing? I was working with Donny Osmond, mm-hmm. and I've got a Donny Osmond calendar.
Somebody else that's very important to you, the Pope, because faith is important to you, and mm-hmm. you're going to be performing for him in December.
I've got a concert there with Lionel Richie and Bonnie Tyler.
What a lineup, Susan.
I met Lionel Richie some years ago when I was at a concert in Glasgow, and he's very nice. A very talented man. It's going to be magical. It's going to be really... It's a great honour to be asked to perform in front of the Silmas. I feel quite humble, yeah. I feel quite humble.
Back into rehearsals because you've got this big 10 tour coming up in March.
I'll be all over Britain. I'll be starting off in Dundee and ending in Edinburgh. It's a mixture of songs, some you know, some you don't know, some new things, and some you might be familiar with. I won't tell them too much though because I would like them to come along and see for themselves. It's about Jai McDowell. Mm-hmm. He's a lovely guy.
He is lovely, yeah.
Beautiful voice, and people called the Soul Nation Choir.
This is going to be different from anything you've done before. Why is that?
Well, the setting will be different. It'll not be the classical one with behind the music stands. It'll not be like that. Mm-hmm. It'll be more informal. People can get up and dance. I'll be doing more up-tempo stuff.
Every night I lie in bed, the brightest colours fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake.
And we're coming up to a very special time of year. What is Christmas like for you, Susan?
Christmas is about being with friends and family, having Santa, wee Santa Claus, mistletoe.
Oh, look out, Jai.
Yeah, exactly. I love Christmas. It's about peace and goodwill. It's about carol services. It's about kids getting excited. The whole shebang, I love it all.
What's your favourite thing to do at Christmas?
I pull a cracker. You take that any way you like.
What's been your best Christmas ever?
My best Christmas ever? Oh no, that's going back a bit now. My best Christmas ever, when I had my mum and dad alive, obviously they're not here, but when they were around, everybody came through for Christmas dinner. It was traditional, you know.
And what about the new year? What are you hoping for that? So we've got the tour. What else is coming up?
I worked towards the tour and possibly another album coming out after it. It never stops. I hope it doesn't anyway.
That's 10 years on, an incredible 10 years. Do you ever think there'll be a time that you'll want to just say, right, that's enough, I'm going to step away, or would you like to just keep going?
I'll be singing when I'm 70. I want to keep going for as long as the public wants me, yeah. You know? And I think they do.
Coming up, the movie.